Hi, kindergarten. This week, when we read our stories, we're going to be talking more about how to draw conclusions. So I wanted to bring your attention again to this little picture, and you're going to see a little girl holding what looks to be a present. You're also going to see an equal sign, and then you see the word happy three times. Happy, happy, happy. So what conclusion can you make just by looking at these pictures and by using your prior knowledge of things that you already know? What can you say about this picture? What conclusion can you make? You can conclude that the girl feels happy, okay? Because you see her smiling, you see her holding the gift. It brings her happiness. What kind of a feeling do you get when somebody gives you a gift? Do you feel happy? Yeah. You know, when you receive the gifts for your birthday or a special, you know, occasion, maybe it's a sacrament like baptism or communion. Maybe it's, you know, just a party that you're hosting and somebody brings you something special. It makes you have that happy feeling, right? Because you feel special. And that's probably how this little girl feels. We can make that conclusion, okay? So before we do our little story read aloud today, I want you to think and remember that when you listen to a selection and look at the pictures and you add your prior knowledge of what you already know, that's how you make conclusions. And this is a really important skill to do to better understand stories and know what's going on. Okay? So our story today is called A Prairie Dog Whom. Okay? As I read this, you can also go back and rewind this and listen to it a second time before we go over some questions together. Okay? The title again is called A Prairie Dog Whom. A prairie dog is not a dog, but a rodent, much like a squirrel. The prairie dog is also a fine builder. The prairie dog's home is underground. With its long curved claws, it digs a deep tunnel. The mound of dirt from digging helps keep water out of its home and makes a good lookout tower. A prairie dog often sits up on the top of this mound watching for enemies. And enemies, you know, are people almost like predators, which we learned about last week. During learning about habitats, enemies are people that you don't get along with, okay? The burrow home is surprisingly large. A room close to the entrance is a safe place to listen for enemies. Nesting and sleeping rooms are farther down. Some tunnels lead to back doors. These are important. If a hungry snake, ferret, or badger crawls into the burrow, the prairie dog must have ways to escape. Okay, so if you need to listen to the story again, you can go back and rewind and listen before we do some questions together, okay? So what I want to ask you, boys and girls, is how are the beaver and the prairie dog alike? Last week we read stories about beavers and we learned lots of factual information about them. So how are they alike? Well, they're both rodents, okay? And rodents' teeth are good for gnawing. Now, the beaver's teeth were good for gnawing large branches and trees, okay? And we can also make that conclusion that since a prairie dog is a rodent, that it also uses its teeth to gnaw, okay? And its teeth are good for that. So let's talk about this question now. It says, what conclusion can we draw about how a prairie's dog's mound of dirt and a beaver's dam are alike? So let me read that again. What conclusion can you draw about how a prairie dog's mound of dirt and a beaver's dam are alike? How are they similar? They both hold back water, okay? Very good, boys and girls. So you can keep comparing and contrasting through this story how beavers and how prairie dogs are alike. Make sure you go back and review it and see if there's any other conclusions you could draw. Thanks, guys.